Greetings everyone, Andy Dukes here again, and welcome to our latest live stream on the new ConnectedRide Cradle. You'll be particularly interested in this stream if you want to use your smartphone for map navigation, if you haven't got the latest 10.25 inch TFT screen on your bike, and if you use or are considering buying a BMW Motorrad communication system. I've got Christian in our Munich studio who's going to tell us all about the new Cradle that makes all of this possible and show us how easy it is to work. So a warm welcome to you, Christian, and thanks for joining.
And hello, BMW Motorrad community.
So last week, Christian, we put a shout out to this community for questions about the ConnectedRide Cradle, and we have loads in. So we'll be answering as many of these as we can during the next 20 minutes or so. So why don't we start right at the beginning then, Christian? Who's the Cradle aimed at and which riders should be interested in it?
So basically it's for any riders who just want to use the smartphone-based map navigation onto their bikes. And we already had included the map functionality on the TFT instrument on the bikes, as more or less as a hidden feature. And we see the community starting to pick up on that, and that's where we start thinking about it. Hey, how can we make it even better and greater experience for these bikes? And that's what we came up with the BMW Motorrad Connected Cradle.
Superb. So what are the main benefits then for our riders?
So first of all, you have a charging possibility for your phone, like for example via the QI standard or via the USB charging on the side of the Cradle itself. As well as the map navigation directly onto your smartphone. And one of my personal favorites is that you can basically use the multi-controller on the left handlebar to actually control the BMW Motorrad Connected app within the Cradle. For example, for the map functionality, for quick access to your current waypoints, and to add waypoints like, for example, a gas station.
Yeah, fantastic. And you don't even have to take your gloves off, which is an even bigger bonus. So I see you're not completely on your own there in the studio. You've got an older GS and you've got a new XR there with you. So which models is the controller suitable for, and what exactly do you need on your bike to be able to make this Cradle compatible?
Basically, it's really simple. All we need to have is the navigation preparation onto your vehicles, like for example, on the older vehicles, or for example, here in the new XR. And then you can plug in the Cradle and you're good to go. So you have a wide range of vehicles that is capable of holding the Cradle itself and then using the BMW Motorrad Connected app within that Cradle to experience the navigation or the onboard computer itself.
Okay, fine. But what if you don't have preparation for a navigation device already? Can this be retrofitted maybe?
Yes, basically it can on many different bikes. So what we recommend is ask your local dealer for a retrofit solution for your specific bike.
Okay. Do you have to have the nav prep to be able to access the functions of the BMW Motorrad Connected app like map navigation and vehicle data though?
Yeah, absolutely. So basically, if you have like the TFT dash displays, you can connect your BMW Motorrad Connected app. But as long as you have the navigation preparation itself, all you need to do is use the Cradle, connect your BMW Motorrad Connected app to that Cradle, and then the app pops up with the connectivity hub and the Cradle mode, and then you can use it on your bike while riding.
Okay, but how about actually pairing the Cradle with your phone then, Christian? Can you take us through those steps?
Very well. We try to make this as easy as possible. So as soon as you plug in your Cradle into your bike and it has power, all you need to do is open up the connectivity hub on your bike and then click on connect new device, and then it pops up the Cradle itself. You could pair it, and then the BMW Motorrad Connected app is paired to the Cradle, and you have all the functionality that we just described.
Easy. Even I could do that. Superb. So go on then, Christian. So tell me what else is new on the latest version of the BMW Motorrad Connected app then.
Sure. So we bumped the major version number, which means this is always about new functionalities, new features. But as you do know, we always try to make enhancements on the app and try to bring fixes that the community reports to us within the new version. And this version is huge. It's not about only the Cradle. There are lots of plenty of other functionalities within. So just to give you a brief overview, first of all, on iOS, we brought up the dark mode. Itself. Android is coming soon, so stay tuned for that. And we did hear the community about lots of different topics about like navigation commands during phone call, even the loudness of the navigation commands are now adjustable within the app. And as you do know, you have like this easy PY access on your bikes itself. We brought that into the search within the app, so it's even more easier to add a waypoint, for example, the nearest park, restaurant, or gas station, which you need just right now in the moment. It's all accessible via the top search bar.
Wow, there's loads more, and I think even more than you've told me about today. So, okay, cool, then back to the Cradle. So there are people out there now watching and wondering if their particular brand of phone will fit the dimensions of the Cradle. So what's your answer to them, Christian? Is there a list online somewhere that shows exactly which smartphones the unit's compatible with, or?
So there's a list of the minimal size and the maximal size of your of the Cradle that can fit the smartphones. So just compare your specific smartphone to this sizes, minimal and maximal, and see if the smartphone will fit to the Cradle. The Cradle itself is adjustable to fit as many different phones as possible. But if you're unsure, just look up into the manual of your smartphone. Which size do you have? Compare it to the minimal and maximal size of the Cradle, fitting possibilities, and if it's like within that range, you're good to go.
Okay, super. So a lot of the latest phones, they cost a small fortune though, don't they? And I know that from some of the online bike forums that riders often worry about the effects of vibration on their phones. So is this something that's been considered in the design of this Cradle, Christian?
Yes, it is considered. So the navigation preparation itself has a vibration dampening already included, so there should be as less as possible vibrations coming to the Cradle and coming to your phone. But we always recommend, since there's a variety of different smartphones within the market, to stick to the manual and the specifications of your manufacturer of your smartphone and really stick to these regarding vibrations on the motorcycle.
Yeah, okay, agreed. Read the instructions of your smartphone manufacturer. That's the advice there. Can you fit the Cradle yourself, Christian, or does this need to be done via your local BMW Motorrad dealer?
You can do this by yourself. So as long as you have your Cradle and your smartphone connected, it's more or less just one push to the navigation preparation and you're done.
Super. That sounds fantastic. So I believe there are some how-to videos that have already been posted online, but seeing as we're here today and you've got bikes there in the studio, why don't we actually show how easy it is to fit your phone into it? So can you take us through those steps, Christian?
Yeah, sure. So as soon as you bought the BMW Motorrad Connected Cradle, fitting it to the is just more or less two steps. So the first one is put it in, push the right arm onto your smartphone, then screw the lock tight on the lower right side, and then you have fitted your smartphone to the Cradle, but always make sure it's like clamped right into that and locked in tight.
Seems pretty straightforward to me. Okay, thanks for the demo, Christian. Now, there may be still some questions from our community that we've not answered yet, so if you can stick around for a few minutes more, hopefully we can work our way through some of these together. So yeah, let's see if we can have the first one up on our screens, please, guys. Okay, this doesn't seem like it would work for bikes with a new 10.25 inch TFT.
So yes, it doesn't work with the large TFT disc cranes, but it do work with a broad variety of other models, and two of them are seen here in the studio to fit the connected Cradle. In the large screens, you always have the Mac functionality directly included into your screen itself. And for the other bikes, you could use the BMW Motorrad Connected app together with the Cradle to experience the same kind of functionality.
Brilliant. Sounds like you've covered almost everything off there. Thanks for that, Christian. Okay, next question, please. Yeah, good question. I should have asked that one myself. When will it be available? I didn't find it on the BMW website. Thanks for that, Maurice.
So in the EU, it's already available. The other markets will follow soon within the next couple of weeks and month. And some of you might notice that the BMW Motorrad Connected app is released in the version 4.0 worldwide. So it's prepared for the new functions.
Okay, superb. So not too long to wait for some. Some have already got it. Oh, a big long question. I'll read this one out, Christian. Okay, it would have been easier to use the already existing Bluetooth connection to the TFT for the transmission of the controller's inputs, so you would be able to use any smartphone holder. Why so complicated? Just to earn more money, or is there a technical reason? Good question. That's from Oliver Peters.
Very good question. So on the newer bikes, on the TFT dash, we have a Bluetooth connection. That's absolutely correct. But we have other bikes within the portfolio and even in the community that do not have the Bluetooth functionality already included. So we try to figure out a solution that fits to a broad range of different vehicles to get the experience of the app to a broad community. And the BMW Motorrad Connected app is the, not the app, the Cradle is, together with the app, is the answer to that.
Okay, hopefully that's answered your question, Oliver. Okay, can we have another one up on the screen, please? Can we adjust the volume of music using the wheel? Someone who likes to listen to some tunes while he's riding, that's from Tony Beckett.
So as soon as you connect it to your TFT dash instrument, so your smartphone is connected to the TFT, your helmet is connected to the TFT, you can use it on this bike's the motor controller together with a BMW helm connected system. You can control it. Yes.
Superb. So you can blast your tunes as much as you want. Brilliant. Next question, please. Weather protection, a rain cover. Okay, so does it offer any kind of weather protection? I guess that's what's being asked. And is there a rain cover for it?
Yeah, so the Cradle itself is weather protected, but it does not cover your phone additionally as a weather protection. So what you can do for that before to check if you, like for example, are going on a ride during a wet environment, check your so-called IP rating on your smartphone. And if this IP rating is high enough, your smartphone should be weather protected for wet environments. But again, it's basically within the smartphone manufacturers that make these ratings for your smartphone. And we do not offer an additional weather protection with the Cradle.
Okay, so the advice there is, read the small print from the manufacturer of the smartphone. Okay, next question, please. Can I lock my phone in the Cradle? That's from Victor.
Yeah, not directly. So you are able to lock the Cradle within the navigation preparation and to lock it safe. But the Cradle is designed in a way that you can always easy pick up your smartphone from the Cradle. So recommend to you, as long as you park your bike, take your phone with you, and if you go for riding again, just plug it in and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, becomes like an automatic thing after a while, doesn't it, for sure? Okay, super, thanks for that. Okay, next question, please. Can we have the Cradle installed, but phone on other mount and still have it working?
Could you please bring up the question again after to hear and read it twice? Sorry.
Okay, here we go.
Can
you have the Cradle installed, but phone on another mount and still have it working?
So my personal recommendation would not to do it. Basically, if you have the Cradle, just plug in your phone. But it's a Bluetooth connection, so as long as you're near the Cradle, it should be possible, yes. I don't believe that we tried it yet.
Okay, well maybe try that and let the community know. Super. Okay, have we got another question on the screen, please? Ah, good question, Laura. Is it compatible with BMW Motorrad's communication system?
Yeah, for example, the Fit4All system, yes, absolutely. You can pair that to your smartphone and then you just hear the music, or just pair it to your TFT dash instrument, as you already used to know, and use your Cradle for consuming the map.
Super. The answer is yes. Okay, if we've got any more questions on the screen, please, guys. All right, this one's from Brett Skolman. Can it display current speed in a large size when not using GPS function? Good question, Brett.
Very good question. Sorry, Brett, no, we can't yet, but it's an excellent feature, Chris. Thank you for that.
All right, who knows what'll happen in the future. All right, we're just about out of time already. So there you have it. The Cradle's in dealers now, so it's a good excuse for a ride out, if you ask me, to see how it fits on your bike. Be careful though, if you're like me and like to treat yourself, you'll come away with a lot more than just a connected ride Cradle, especially at this time of the year. You've been warned. Right, that's all folks. Glad you could join us today and I hope we've answered all your questions. If not, please continue to reach out for us and we'll do our best to do that. Thanks again to Christian for joining and thanks to all of you for watching. Stay safe out there, whatever you're doing. And until next time, it's farewell from me, Andy Dukes. Bye for now.